I have a job that my whole job centers around you. I gotta get to know you. So, once you, pretty much we're gonna start that first week of school, calling people down. Come see me, come see my office, all that good stuff. Okay, because by the time we get to eighth grade, we'll have gone through a lot together. In a good way. Okay, so you took the tour. It's a little overwhelming. It's a big building, right? You will have it down in about a week. I promise. You're gonna hear, right? A week?
Yeah.
You got it. You're gonna hear from our survivors. Hopefully you recognize them. You went to school with them. They are going to be, which end am I starting up? I'm gonna start here, okay. Mix them up. All right, guys, please give your undivided attention to your soon-to-be seventh graders.
Hi, fifth grade, I'm Mrs. Wallin. I'm the sixth grade counselor, which means that next year I would be the seventh grade counselor because our counselors travel with you, which is pretty awesome. So I would be going on with them next year. So I brought together this panel to talk about what it's like to be a sixth grader. They are our experts. They have survived sixth grade just about. And they have a lot of great information for you. Hopefully we'll have enough time at the end to do some questions. So, Ava, stand on up, girl. Ava is going to talk about one of our favorite topics, right? What is it?
Lunch and recess.
I think we might as well start off on a high topic. All right, Ava, take it away.
Okay, so lunch is kind of different from elementary school. There's a lot more food choices. Like there's sushi, there's a salad bar, there's a sandwich bar. Mrs. Wong wanted me to add in the pizza. It's very good here.
Pizza is awesome.
There's smoothies. There's Chick-fil-A. There's so many other things. And then there's also a snack stand over there where you can get like popcorn and ice cream. School just
has food. Is this their good for lunch?
Are they staying here for lunch?
Not today. You'll get to do it every day next year.
Yeah.
Anything else? Recess.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, lunch is 30 minutes long. After 15 minutes, you have three options. You can either stay here, or if it's nice out, you can go outside. There's a field, there's a basketball court, there's a track, and then they have there's some balls out there, or you can bring in your own. Or you can go to the library where you can like, get out a book, or like read or work. So, yeah.
Or you can stay here.
Oh, yeah,
and
you can sit here.
Awesome. Thank you.
And, oh, did you mention that you can sit wherever you want?
Oh, yeah.
And with whoever you want?
Yeah.
And I think Ava made a great point in our last session about that you get to meet so many new people here, and that doesn't matter. You don't have to sit with the same group of kids every day. You can change it up, mix it up, make some new friends. And we'll talk more about that in a little bit. All right, Lauren. How are you today?
Good.
Oh, great. Okay, what are you
going to
talk about?
Homework.
Oh, everybody's favorite topic. Stand up.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is probably a great drop down for lunch and recess. Homework is, well, the most different thing about it, and also the most difficult, is that you now have six classes with homework instead of just your usual one teacher who teaches everything, plus a special. Although, sometimes classes won't assign homework, like gym or art, and you'll eventually get used to it. It gets very hard at the beginning because of the transition, but it's easier in the middle of the year. It helped me personally with prioritizing because you have a lot of tests and assignments to balance with all your different subjects. And I know last year I didn't find my agenda very useful, but this year it's way better, not just for doodles, it's also for homework now. And I would say about 15 minutes per subject on average for homework. And if you think you're going to be busy that night and you think you have a lot of homework, you can do, if you don't have orchestra, band, or chorus, you can do that advisory. You can try to at the end of the day at SOS. And if you have trouble, you can go to that teacher during an advisory and they can clarify and help you with that homework. Most of my grades are completion grades, as in you complete the whole paper and you get credit for doing that. Although you do want to try to get most of the answers correct. So you want to take your time with your homework, even though it's not the fun of middle school.
Thank you, Lauren. That was awesome. We're going to talk about that time. She talked about advisory and SOS. One of our experts here is going to talk about the schedule, because the schedule is very different. We know that it can be overwhelming, but there are opportunities throughout the school day for you to get homework done and check in with teachers. All right, my gentlemen on the end here, we're going to start talking about classes a little bit. And so Lucas and Dominic have divided and conquered some of our specials. So our encores, and we have more encore options here at the middle school. You don't get to choose your encores coming into sixth grade, but you do in seventh and eighth. So Lucas is going to start. You have PE, health, and music, correct? All right.
So PE, health, and music. So the main difference between PE in middle school and elementary school is that for PE in middle school, you have to have a gym shirt that you are required to wear every day in gym. Health is pretty much the same. There are four teachers for health and PE. Mr. Rufnack, who's Dr. Nice, Mr. Mack, who I
also very nice.
I've heard he's nice. Miss Tompkins and Miss Lewis.
Also wonderful.
There are no. And the teachers for music are Mr. Reeve and Miss Lindell. In music, it's a little bit different. You do less singing and you learn more about like different instruments in the orchestra. And you also learn how to learn all the notes. So if you play piano, that's a bit easier. So there's the keyboard library, the keyboards for you to kind of play with the interview.
Anything else? Great, awesome. All right, Dominic is going to cover facts, tech ed, art. Did I get them all? Okay, tell them what facts is.
So facts stands for family and consumer science. And there's two main sections in facts. The first one is sewing. Ready to learn to sew. That sewing is hard at first, but then it's easy. And in sewing, you make a pillowcase, so you get two different fabrics. There's like sports fabric, so you can get flyers or fillings or needles fabric, and you can make a pillowcase out of it. And after sewing, you have a babysitting unit where you learn how to babysit and like stuff about babysitting. And then after that, you have nutrition where you learn nutrition. And then after that, you have cooking, where you have a bunch of cooking labs. You can make cookies, muffins, pizza, all sorts of that stuff. There's ovens and microwaves and oven beds and like doors and cool stuff. And so then tech ed design is really fun. You learn basically about the modern technology and stuff. So first you go through the design process, which is basically how companies design products and stuff and the prototypes and everything. Then you make a box. It's really fun. You make a box. Like you cut, you have to make you have to put a potato chip in the box and ship it, and if it doesn't break, you get a good grade. And so you have to learn how to like cut it out so it folds into a box, and you can put bubble wrap and pot holes and stuff in it to make it not break. And you get to make a picture frame. Well, you have a picture frame that you use a laser engraver to burn the wood to make the design on it. And yeah, I can see it looks pretty cool, right? So it is cool. And then you can make a keychain out of a 3D printer. And this class is really fun. It's a really nice school teacher with it too, Mr. Kelly. So it's like probably my favorite encore. It's a really cool encore. Then you have art. art is like a cool, unique art experience because you get to make a mask out of copper. You get a stick and like carve a face into the copper, make a stick, and you put it into the, is it sink? You put it in a bunch of toxic chemicals and it makes it black, and then it goes away and you get steel wool and you rub it, and toxic chemicals smell really bad. It's like rotten eggs. Oh, it's sulfur. Sulfur, that's what it is.
Yeah. I'm not talking about toxic, they're fine.
It's fun. And so then you get to make, there's also this one painting, I forget what it's called, I think it's called the Tempura painting. It's like a symmetrical painting where everything's symmetrical. You use paints and colors, and it's cool. Like, all three of those specials, or not courses, are fun.
How many art teachers?
There's two art teachers. I don't know.
Mr.
McLaughlin, and I don't know.
The other teacher is Miss Barbara Collins. He only has Mrs. McLaughlin, or Mr. McLaughlin. All right, on to Ines. Your topic, my dear? Okay, great. So we're going to start talking about your schedule. So Ines is going to talk about the core classes and then how we're divided up here at the middle school into teams.
So on the first day of school, you get your team and like you go to and see your teachers. And so when you get your schedule and stuff, it'll tell you who you have. And so you could like take a tour of like your pod and you could see like all your teachers. And so like for the first few weeks of school, you're just learning how to do everything. And on your team, like your teachers will help you. And sometimes they'll do fun things like watch movies and stuff. But so the core classes, like you could have an off-team class if you're more advanced. And sometimes there's advanced classes on your team, so you don't have to leave your team and go to a different floor. And
what are the teams right now?
Oh, A, B, C, and Crossroads.
Great, awesome, thank you.
Does anybody know why we have teams in middle school? Did you guys hear that? So you're not all crowded, you're not all just thrown in the one spot. You are separated. You're coming from like a pretty small environment, Radnor Elementary School. And we're gonna throw you in with two other elementary schools and about 20 new students. So that's a lot of kids. So one of the things that middle schools love to do to make your learning environment smaller and more comfortable is we put you on teams. Those team teachers talk to each other every day about students, about the projects they assign, about the tests that they have coming up, to make it easier for you to figure out how this whole thing works. Because when you get to high school, then you're just thrown right in. We're all mixed up all over the place, and you've got to navigate 10 teachers and all their schedules and assignments. But in middle school, we like you to start off kind of slow. So it's a nice transition from elementary to high school. We're kind of a bridge, if you think about it. Right? So you're not thrown into having to manage too much. The structure's there for you. Okay? Good. All right, Liv is going to talk about our schedule, and then Mrs. Ottaviano is going to add some things to it, because the schedule is definitely something much different, but we can promise you that you'll learn it within a couple of weeks. Liv?
So there's 8 days in a cycle, days 1 through 8, and on even days, you'll have 2 encore classes, and then on odd days, you'll have 2 different encore classes, so it switches every other day. The periods are 46 minutes. Like your core classes and online classes are 46 minutes. And you also have a callback, which is you'll see one teacher again. So like on days 1 and 5, you'll see one teacher, and then on days 2 and 6, you'll go to a different core class. There's a 34-minute advisory, which is time to get like work done. And some days you can just like read. It's when you go to band, chorus, and orchestra. And there's an SOS at the end of the day, and that's time you can also do some homework or like a only 5 minutes. Can anyone how fast you pack up? And you have 30 minutes for lunch.
Thank you.
This is probably I'm going to jump on it. Thank you.
Okay, so at the end of the summer, you're going to receive something in the mail that looks kind of like this.
It won't look exactly like this. It's confusing. I do not expect you to understand what this says. So you're going to bring it with you on your first day of school, and your core teachers, so your science, your social studies, your math, your language arts teacher, one of those teachers is going to help you rewrite this in a way that you like can get and understand. Because this is just like numbers and crazy things, and it looks like you go to class in like 12 different areas. This is your schedule for the entire year, and it's tough to read. You're always gonna have the period that you have to attend, what class it is, the different marking periods the class meets, the cycle day it runs on, the room number of the teacher, and the building. That's a lot of information. So don't worry, we're gonna make this much more manageable. And sixth grade survivors, how long did it take you to learn your schedule? Ah, the rewritten one is still in your locker. I love it. Wasn't it easier to read than this? Okay, how long did it take you to learn your schedule? A day? A day? A week? About a week. Listen, it's different for everybody, but I promise you, you will get this. Do not panic. Our teachers are very understanding. They know that this is not easy, okay? They're used to helping kids figure out where to go, when to go, all that good stuff. So don't panic. Okay, who's next?
Bryn is gonna talk to us about Crossroads. Now, did Mr. Rendelick and Mr. Caney come to your school? Talk about our Crossroads and the integrated program for sixth graders. Wonderful. Bryn is a current Crossroadian, and so she's going to talk a little bit about her experience.
So Crossroads is a classroom with 40 kids. We do lots of presentations and projects. We use a lot of creativity and we go on these field trips.
What's it going to say? What kind of field trips?
We go to Maryland on one field trip. We see an opera at the Academy of Music. We go to New York and see where immigrants used to live.
That's fun.
Is it fun?
Yes.
She loves it. All right, Charlie is going to share some information about the bus loop and our walk to Wayne, which is something unique about the middle school because we're so close to Wayne. Students are allowed to walk there after school. So Charlie's going to give us some more information on that.
So walk to Wayne, at the beginning of the year, your parents signed a form that says that you can go to walk to Wayne, even though it's not a school activity. So walk through Wayne, you should probably bring money for the different stores there. I don't know if you've been there before, but you probably have. Then you know the square, Wayne Square, and then the bus loop is right out there where you guys came in, and there's a little sign that says where your bus is at the time. So your bus can either be up closer to the baseball fields or back toward the other side of the school. And then your bus picks up at 7 o'clock or 7:30 or any time in between there. And then that's it.
All right, Charlie, thank you. Can I clarify one point?
Yes.
Listen. Okay. Walk to Wayne is very important, right? You're gonna get, in addition to your schedule in the mail, you're gonna get a packet of information and permission slips. And do you want your picture taken? Can we put it on the website? There's gonna be like a whole bunch of permissions. In that packet is gonna be a little permission that says, can my child can walk into Wayne? And this means when the teachers actually sometimes occasionally walk into Wayne, maybe it's a treat at the class, you go get pizza. Maybe it's to walk to the train station if you're in Crossroads, right? That's what that is. Walking to Wayne at 3 o'clock on Fridays to hang out. Totally different, okay? Two different things. That's not up to us if you can walk to Wayne at 3 o'clock on Friday. That's up to your parents. That's separate, that's out of school, okay? That's something you and your parents agree on. We still care about you. We monitor kind of what's going on in Wayne, but it's a separate, then it's separate from school. Questions about that? Because I know that that's a big one. That if you go during the school day with the teacher, that's part of that permission. After school is not part of the school stuff. If your parents and you have worked out that you're gonna go on a Tuesday after school, then you and your parents have made that arrangement. We don't have anything to do with that. Let me explain some of that when we come back to the larger group, okay? One more thing about Wayne. Go ahead.
Yeah, you said you get out at 3:00.
It's so much better than 3:30. I agree.
Well,
the school day starts at 8 o'clock. I know. Well, that will have to be adjusted.
I wake up at like 6:10.
Ready? We have one more presenter, survivor. And then I'll answer more questions.
So what is the one topic we did not talk about yet that is on everyone's mind? Does a fifth grader know?
Clubs?
Not clubs.
When we go to school and leave school?
No. It's usually the number one thing that kids want to know about when they come to the middle school.
Oh, yeah. Lockers.
Lockers. William Referee is the third, is going to tell us about lockers.
Lockers are your combination and where they are is easy to remember. When you get your lock and when you tour the school, like in the summer, you might want to like practice at home. They're not that scary. Like many kids think that they're scary or not. You can organize them by keeping a calendar for the days of the week. So maybe on day one, you might have music and gym. Maybe on day two, you might have art and facts. You might want to keep a calendar. You might want to keep a like holder for like that's magnetic so it can stick inside your locker, pencils. And you should hang your backpack up and you should stack your books if you don't need them for that like period that you can go to your locker. You can go to your locker in the beginning when you get here, right after lunch, and at SOS.
Do some teachers let you go to your locker throughout the day?
Yeah. Yes, most teachers do let you go to your locker if you forget something.
Something that Ina has added is that at the beginning of the school year, teachers are very flexible in understanding that you're getting used to having a locker and keeping yourself organized. But I would say, what would you say, after Thanksgiving, they're expecting that you've got the books that you need and are, you know, ready to go. All right.
Friends are coming back from their tour. Web leaders are following. Katie, can you open that door for me? Just tell everybody to come on in quietly.
They can do a few questions, and then web leaders, I'm gonna dismiss. Come on in, guys, have a seat at that long table. All right, please give our sixth grade panel a round of applause. Thank you very much, sixth grade. Please give our web leaders a round of applause. Thank you, web leaders, for touring us.